So you said that the film took, what, 10 months to edit?
Mm-hmm.
Did you start to piece together the initial first edit with the interview first and then piece in the archival footage, or how did you do that? How did you piece together?
We watched everything, and it took how long? Like, it took
a long time. A
couple months, almost. Watched all the footage, and then we watched all the archival footage that we had. So it was probably around 150 hours. And with our editor, because she likes to watch everything. So then we kind of just let, I mean, we pulled selects from interviews, from, you know, and then we kind of let our editor tackle it the way she wanted to. She generally cuts the opening of the film first. That's how she works. So that was what she cut first. And
which wasn't the
it's
opening.
It's not the opening.
It was a starting place when we first saw it.
It was the opening.
It was the opening for a long time, yeah.
Till almost, I mean, through the rough cut.
Yeah. Yeah.
But then it changed. But so that's how she starts. She's seen everything and then she pieces together the opening. And that was the first thing we saw. And then she would do sequences. We knew there had to be a sequence about spiritual midwifery. We knew we wanted to tell Ina May's first birth story. We knew that we had to touch on all the historical aspects of the farm, how it came to be, the caravan. We wanted to introduce the other midwives. You know, like, we knew things that we had to touch on. So she would just kind of tackle those bit by bit. And that was for a long time.
Yeah.
And then it sort of got pieced together, probably, I mean, 6 months later. You know, it was like, It was really a long process, but so that's how she works. She creates sequences. She as you can see in the film, it's really a weaving between past and present. So, you know, it would be like we would touch on something historical and then come to the present day, and trying to use as much verite as possible. There were a lot of interviews, and our whole intention when we began the film was to make a verite film. And then we ended up with like 20 sit-down interviews, and we're like, wait, this isn't what we wanted. But so, you know, she really has such, Kate Amend, who's this, our amazing editor, has such a gift at pulling out verite. Stuff that we wouldn't have dreamed would be in the film is, you know, these sort of offhand moments. And so that's kind of how it started.
Well, what was it about the initial rough cut opening that made you backtrack and say, let's change it?
You know, when we watched it the first time, when we went in and sat down and watched it, Mary and I both had tears streaming down our faces. We loved it so much. Like, it was just so amazing to see all the rough footage turned into what felt like a true opening moment to us, and we felt like just so grateful to Kate for what she had put together, and liked it, and I still like that opening quite a bit. But we showed it, we had a rough cut screening, and people were just not as like engaged in it. For the energy was like a little bit lower. It was a more intimate sort of open. And I think probably what I think probably happened is that if you know Ina May and you know her work already, she has a charisma that pops off even if she's just sitting at her desk typing. But if you don't know who she is, you need to be sort of told right away that she is the rock star midwife that she is. And so that it was that shift in tone that we felt like, okay, we've made a quiet film. Let's not open it like so quietly. We need to give her like a little bit of like, we actually gave her stage time, you know, like that the film opens with her on stage talking to people, so that if you weren't immediately familiar with her, you would like get right away that like people cared a lot about what this woman has to say.
And the audience needed to know, you know, that she lived on the farm and that she delivered over 1,000 babies, and that, you know, people felt like they wanted to know so that they could like sit back and relax and enjoy the movie having that knowledge. And so
yeah, like, so we felt like we had to just ground
it. Yeah, because they were like, wait, what's going on? Yeah, who is this? You know, if for people who didn't know her. So we changed the open, but we changed it very late.
Mm-hmm.
Probably, you know, I don't know, towards the end.
Yeah.
And then some of the other shots you mentioned, like the graveyard shot and things like that. What was your decision behind not using some of those, you said?
We had like a 3-hour rough cut probably at a certain point. And maybe it was like a 2-hour by the time we had like larger groups of...
When that was still in.
Yeah, we had a few rough cut screenings with documentary filmmakers. That we knew and that Kate, our editor, knew, and it was, we had sort of gotten to that place where we weren't able to see, you know, what was happening, and so a lot of our decisions were made taking their feedback into account. I mean, we didn't take all the feedback into account, obviously, but if we had a couple of people who would say, you know, I'm not sure why that's in there, or it didn't necessarily play the way we thought it was playing. If that came up more than one or two or three times, you know, that I think that had a big effect on
I think
our
also
thinking.
That scene, having been there, you know, it was one of those moments as a filmmaker where that was a very moving moment, just to be there and to have Ina May speak so candidly about experiences in her life while standing in a cemetery. She talked about death, and it was beautiful. The footage looked beautiful. And so we were quite attached to it for those reasons. And you know, and when somebody comes in and says, I don't understand why this is here, and consistently, you know, a number of people saying that, it's like you have to let go, you know? And so we're like, okay, we'll just try it, to watch it without it, and then it never went back in. And there's a number of scenes, and some of them are on the DVD. There are a number of extras, so... and digitally, you can get them also. So a lot of the scenes that were cut out, we also had a goal of making the film 90 minutes. So we feel like that's a good length for a documentary, and much longer than that is, I don't know, too long. So, you know, all the non-essential scenes that came out are now on the DVD. So that's really amazing to be able to offer them to people, even though they're not in the film.
That's true. We all along were like posting on Facebook the labor analogy that sort of went with where we were in the editing process. So that cutting was like, you know, trying to push an 11-pound baby out.
Yeah.